Now that we know how the UI in OBS Studio works, it's time to take a dive into profiles and scene collections and discuss how you might utilize these to really get the most out of the software. Any high-tier live production needs a variety of scenes to show and quick, precise switching between them. The Elgato Stream Deck gives you 15 keys with customizable LCD screens behind each one that can execute macros, application launchers, and do scene switching and source meeting for OBS, and you can nest folders for more actions and unlimited power! Grab yours today via the link in the video description. I'm Meeplesbox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and welcome back to my OBS Studio tutorial course. I have many, many more videos on the software in the playlist linked in the video description. Check that before asking questions and check the introduction video to learn how this course works, if you get confused. We're focusing on two specific parts of the OBS Studio software today, two important groupings that work together to vastly expand what you can do with the streaming software. In a nutshell, profiles are different settings presets that you create. These affect your streaming and recording settings, bit rates, resolutions, etc. Scene collections are saved groupings of your scenes and sources, including audio devices. Let's start with profiles. Profiles are the simpler grouping. By creating and naming profiles, you can manage many different groups of streaming and recording settings for different use cases. This is super handy if you do a lot of different forms of streaming and recording. I have a ton of profiles, as I use OBS for just about everything these days. For example, I have different profiles for streaming to Twitch, streaming to Restream for going to Twitch and YouTube at the same time, direct recording to disk in the highest possible quality from consoles, recording my tutorials, webcam recording settings, and so on. By clicking the Profile menu, you have the ability to make a new profile, duplicate an existing profile, rename profiles, and remove profiles, and import and export them. Making a new profile starts with a completely blank slate and empty settings. If you want to make slight variations of existing profiles, such as to make a separate but similar profile for streaming to Twitch and YouTube, or so on, then you can make the profile once, duplicate the profile, and give it a new name. Then make the required tweaks for the different platforms. Exporting your profiles to a folder is a good idea for keeping them backed up. If you need to reinstall your operating system or you somehow corrupt your OBS Studio installation, or if you want to replicate your settings to another PC, using the import-export tool is super handy and can save you a lot of frustration. I keep my most important profiles backed up to just an OBS Profiles folder in my Documents folder. Just remember to make new exports whenever you make major changes to your profiles. My Twitch profile has a base resolution of 1080p, streams to 720p at 5.7 megabits per second, and records at 1080p at 30 megabits per second. My editing tutorials profile, however, is set up to record a full 4K 60fps desktop capture in lossless quality using the NVIDIA encoder. And my webcam profile takes my Logitech Brio webcam at 1080p 60fps and records it to disk. I have many more, but these are some of the various use cases that different profiles are critical for. Profiles affect just about everything in the settings, but they do not affect your audio devices, your microphone inputs, your desktop speaker outputs, and so on. That can be easy to confuse, so you usually want a specific scene collection for each profile. Speaking of which, next is Scene Collections. The Scene Collections menu has the same options as the Profile menu for duplicating, exporting, making new collections, and so on. Where the profiles affect your settings, Scene Collections affect your scenes, sources, and audio devices. Usually, you want specific scene collections to go with your various profiles. I usually name them the same thing to keep it simple, i.e. my Twitch scene collection matches up with my Twitch and Restream profiles. It's also worth noting that your video resolution is still controlled by the profile, so a scene collection of 1080p sources made to run at full 1080p will not look right with a 720p profile. That being said, different scene collections for controlling video devices differently can be super helpful for managing complex setups with multiple monitors, input devices, and so on. And as with profiles, you can export your scene collections for backup. This is more useful for backup than transferring to other PCs, like with profiles, since video devices will show up quite differently across different PCs. Just worth considering. All of my scene collections match up to my profiles. My Twitch scene collection contains the graphics overlays, capture card inputs, and audio mixing for my Twitch live streams. My tutorial recording scene collection contains the desktop capture modes for my three monitors, along with a scene switcher config for recording tutorials. My webcam scene collection contains full-size scenes for my webcams. Pretty straightforward. And that's it. Different customizable profiles and scene collections are part of what makes OBS Studio a very complex and capable streaming and recording software. I now use it for virtually all of my recording and streaming needs. Again, if you're confused about anything, check out my full OBS Studio education course linked in the video description for the rest of the in-depth videos. I do hope this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course has been helpful for you. If it was, dropkick that like button and subscribe for more awesome tech videos. If you like game streaming, come and follow me on Twitch and drop me a message in chat. Until next time, I'm EeplesVox. Happy streaming.
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full masterclass are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more. Also, consider joining us on Patreon to help keep tech education free. Go to patreon.com/eeplesvox to sign up.